Hi everyone. Today is a back rehabilitation, back health, back maintenance. If you need to strengthen your core, if you sit a lot, so many good reasons to do this video. I do these back exercises all the time. I have no back concerns, but I do know how important it is to keep that part of my body nice and strong. So, to start with, all you need is a mat or a comfy floor, and do what you can, when you can, and breeze through it, and let's work together. Okay, here we go. You're gonna come down on your back. This is the best part. Legs are going to be bent for me. I want bent legs, keeps your back protected. If there are no shoulder issues, I would like the small part of your hands under the small part of your back. So that natural part in your back that natural part of your back where there's a curve, that's where I would like your hands. And they're just lightly resting. If that bugs your shoulders, please keep your arms down by the side. So from here, what you're going to do is you're going to think of pushing your back into your hands. So for a count of five, we're going to pull our belly button in, and we're going to think of squishing our hands with our back. For four, three, two, and release. This takes some practicing. This takes a little bit of getting used to. We're going to repeat that again. Belly button towards our spine. Try and squish your hands with your back. It is not about how hard you are going. It's about feeling an activation. Feeling as if, good release there. Feeling as if the core, tummy is tightening. You should feel no pain. Here we go again. Tummy nice and tight. Flat back. Lightly pressing into our hands with our back. Try to keep your shoulders relaxed. And the hardest part, trying to breathe, relax. Trying to breathe while holding that contraction. So we're going to do this a few more times just to really try and practice through. Legs nice and relaxed. Belly button draws in towards our spine. We try and push our back lightly into our hands or into the mat if your hands aren't there. And we're trying to breathe. So as I'm holding this contraction, I can have a natural conversation with you. And relax there. That's taken a lot of practice. I will let you know, this is not easy to contract your abdominal muscles, control your core, while inhaling and exhaling. So here we go together, tummy nice and tight. We're going to push our low back lightly into our hands. I want that nice big breath in. Nice big breath out while maintaining that contraction while keeping our shoulders relaxed. And relax there. We'll come back to that, don't worry. Arms by your side, palms are up. Feet knees together. Shoulders relaxed. We're going to start rocking our knees nice and gently back and forth. So, from here, I don't want you to think on this one. On the last one, we were worried about what our tummy was doing and pushing and breathing. This one, let your knees do what they have to do. Nice, gentle rock from side to side. This is what I'll call immobilization. Immobilization is rocking between two end points in a pain-free, I'll say that in quotations, manner. Not more pain than when you started. This means you may go all the way down both directions. This may mean you go half an inch in one direction and 3 inches in the other. I'm not concerned about how far you are going. I would like a nice, easy rock between two end points in a pain-free manner. Shoulders should be nice and relaxed. Don't worry if your feet are coming off the floor. Don't worry about how far you're going. Nice and gentle, side to side, continuous flow. We're not holding. This is not a stretch. This is a mobilization. So we're continuously moving from side to side. All right, last one here. We're going to come back to the middle. You're going to place your feet about hip width apart. Feet, hips, knees, nice straight line. Heels close to bum. Shoulders relaxed. We're going to keep our weight in our heels. I like lifting my toes up a little bit here to force that weight, but whatever feels comfortable. We're going to lift our bum up off the floor, aiming for shoulders, hips, full range of motion. So if you can only lift and get your bum off the floor enough for me to slide a piece of paper underneath it, and then nice, easy back down, that's great. That's perfect. That's where you're at right now. I think it's great you're here trying it, and we listen to our back. We don't listen to what our head wants us to do. We listen to what our back wants us to do. All right, so weights in our heels. We're gonna lift up only as far as we can. Shoulders, hips, knees at the most nice straight line. Nice slow back down. I'm trying to count on my fingers, but I'm a little bit useless at that. Weights in our heels, shoulders relaxed. We're breathing. So we inhale and exhale. I'm not gonna be over picky on when on this, as long as you're still breathing with me. And we're making sure our knees are staying nice and still. So through this pattern, I don't want our knees rolling in and out. We want our hips, knees, heels, nice straight line, shoulders nice and relaxed. So we're aiming for 12. I'm gonna work through 12 reps with you. But if you've hit 6 and went, that's my max, perfect. Do 6 and hang out, take a little breather. We'll be with you shortly. And then as you work through this video, hopefully, eventually, those muscles will get stronger and you'll be able to do the full set of 12 with us. But in the meantime, if you're laying on your back with those legs bent, that's great. We, those of you that are up to almost 12 for me, here we go. This is our last one. And nice, easy down. All right, from there, we're ending up on our tummy. So, however that looks for you, we're going to come over and we're going to end up on our belly. So, I want arms down by our side for this first one. Legs out long. Heads in neutral. Which means I'm not looking up, I'm not looking down, I'm making a nice long spine. From here, arms are by my side. Arms are going to stay on the mat. So are feet and legs. I'm going to move chest and shoulders just a little bit up off the mat. Shoulders away from ears. And then nice, easy back down. All right, so we have that nice, easy up. Nice and little up. Nice, easy back down. I want you to think as if I'm in your living room, wherever, and I'm doing a gentle little pull on your head. So as I lift up, I'm actually thinking of getting as long as possible. I know every now and then you're going to have a little peek at me, and that's great until you get to know these exercises. But once you do, I want head staring straight down, said long, long spine, and then nice, easy back down. So our tempo speed on this is a good control on the up, a little baby hold, and then a good control on the back. Same thing if you can only get half an inch up off the floor, just enough for me to slide a piece of paper underneath you, that is great, that is wonderful. As you get stronger, your range of motion will improve. Shoulders away from ears will get higher up off the ground. Nice, easy back down. I've got 2 left. We've got 2 to go. Make sure we're breathing. Shoulders away from ears, fingers relaxed, toes relaxed. Head long. Nice, easy back down. We have 1 more to go. Nice, strong up. All that will backfire. Nice, easy back down. Again, if you did not hit 12, don't worry. Join us for the next one. Okay, this one, upper body gets to rest. So you can place hands wherever's comfortable. And then I want upper body hanging out on this one. And now we're gonna lift one straight leg a little bit up off the mat. And then nice control on the down, and we're alternating sides. So on this one, what I want you to think of is if I'm pulling on that leg. So it's not about how high, it's about how long. And I also want us making sure that both of our hips are locked into the ground. So my hip is not lifting as I lengthen through that leg. There's no rotation happening, I'm not twisting, I'm not going from side to side on the mat. My upper body is nice and relaxed, my fingers are relaxed, my toes are relaxed. I'm lifting that straight leg towards the ceiling, getting as long as I can, as if I'm pulling on that foot, keeping the hips locked into the ground. I have that slow lift, that tiny pause, and then that nice, easy back to control on the down. Good, strong lift, get nice and long, nice, easy Two more, one on each side. Nice strong lift. Nice easy down. Last one here is the alternate legs, last one. And we're going to rest there. All right, we have one more strength exercise left. If you're hanging out with me, you're doing a fantastic job. Okay, arms are going to go out. If you have shoulder issues, you can always bring your elbows below shoulder height on this. If not, I want arms out. And let them go wherever is comfortable. Do not force them by your ears, whatever works. And we're going to thumb towards my ceiling. We're going to be lifting opposite leg. And all the principles that we've been talking about are going to apply here as well. So head's going to be rested. And we're going to go opposite arm, opposite leg lift. And again, think as if we're pulling on that leg, pulling on that arm. We're going to get long, nice, easy down. And then we're alternating sides. So I am not concerned about height on this, especially shoulder flexibility is an issue. Don't worry about how high up that arm is going. Keep head nice and relaxed for me. There's no rotation happening, so I'm not rolling down my mat from side to side. My neck is resting, my head's on the mat. I'm controlling the up. I'm trying to think of getting as long as I can, really pushing through my heel, reaching with that arm. Nice, easy down. I almost as if I'm reaching to shake somebody's hand with my thumb up. Good, that's the halfway mark. We have six left, so 3%. Nice big long reach. Nice, easy down. Nice big long reach. And then good control on the down. You're doing a fantastic job. If at any time we need to take a break, you need to pause, you need to have a little rest, hang out, just rest there on your belly in whatever position is comfortable for you. We have two to go, and then we're going to end up on our back. So if you're resting, by all means, you can start heading back over. Here's our last one. Long, 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 long. And nice, easy back down for me. All right, welcome back. Hopefully my hair's okay. Okay, we're going to end up back on our back. And we're going back to where we started. So we're starting with that knee rock. Take your time joining us. Take your time rolling over. Arms down by your side, palms up, feet, knees together, and we're going back to that knee rock. Nice and gentle, side to side. Okay, this is that mobilization where we gently rock between two endpoints in a pain-free range of motion. That means not more pain than when we started. I don't care how far you're going. I don't care if it's equal distance from one side to the other. I want a nice, gentle, continuous flow from one side to the other. Shoulders relaxed. Don't overthink this one. Breathing through it. So nice, good inhales. Nice, good exhales. We got a few more. Hang out with me. You're almost done. You're doing a great job. These exercises here can be done every day. Definitely, again, pay attention to your back. Listen to what your back is saying. In that, yes, we want to get stronger. Yes, you want to feel like you've done something after a workout, but not to the point where you have to go and lay on the couch for 4 days. That means we've done too many reps. Our range of motion has been too big. Maybe we need to take a day off between exercises. So I want us to be able to feel as if we've done something, but not to the point of pain where we need to take a few days off. Really pay attention to what your back is telling you. Good, come on back to the middle, feet apart. We're going back to that one with our hands under the small part of our back. So we're just lightly resting there. And if you have shoulder issues, leave your arms by your side. Feet are apart, toes relaxed, glutes relaxed, shoulders relaxed. Nice big breath. All right, here we go. Belly button pulled in towards our spine. A little bit of a push. Back is in the small part of our hands. 5 second hold. And then a nice, easy relax. This one here, you can do all day, every day, as much as you like. And then a nice, good relax. Good, I want belly button not a strong push, just enough to feel as if we're tightening up our core. Core runs from ribcage to the lower glutes. So I want you to feel as if that, good, relax there. I want you to feel as if that's just tightening. Good. Little bit of a push, belly button in towards our spine. We squish our back into our hands or into our mat. Breathing, we're able to inhale and exhale and relax there. We'll do two more. Shoulders relaxed, belly button in towards our spine. We flatten out, so we're trying to push our back into our hands, just a little bit of a contraction. Try to keep toes relaxed, relax there. And we have one more. Belly button in towards our spine, nice flat back. Breathing, inhales and exhales for me, shoulders relax, and relax there. You guys did a great job. That was really, really well done. I hope your back is feeling much better. Keep up the good work. Again, please pay attention to your low back. We want you to get stronger. We want it to feel better. We definitely don't want things to get irritated or overworked. So great job, and hopefully we'll see you soon.